good afternoon to everyone. So welcome back to today's online session of grade 2. Hope you all are using your time wisely in doing studies. Okay children, thank you so much for the students who are sending me such a beautiful homework. You are very good children, you are doing very good job. Okay children, now in today's class what we are going to learn? Yes, we are going to start our syllabus. Okay children, we are going to start the syllabus of your second standard semester first. Okay children, we are going to start our textbook part today. Till then we have learned the basic part, basic grammar of the English language. Today we are going to start the syllabus of your second standard. Okay children, now take down your textbook children. Okay, standard second semester first, you have to take down your English textbook. Okay children, you need to take your English textbook. Yes children, take your English textbook. Okay, today we are going to learn unit number 1, the poem. Okay children, we are going to learn unit number 1, poem. Okay children, the poem is about an animal. Okay children, the poem is about an animal or an insect. Okay children, we are going to learn the poem which is based on animals and insects. Okay children, do you love animals? Do you love animals children? I love animals. Do you also love the animals? Yes, very good. Now I am going to show you one picture. Can you identify which animal is this? Yes, which animal is this children? The yellow color one, which animal is this? Can you identify this yellow color animal? Which animal is this children? Yes, this is the leopard. What we call it? We call it as a leopard. Okay children, what is the name of this animal? This is leopard, means chirate. Can you see the spots on his body? Can you see the black color spots on the body of the leopard? Yes children, there were many spots, isn't it? There are black color spots. Okay, so this is known as leopard. We call it as in Kannada chirate. Okay, so today now I am going to tell you a poem that is about the leopard. Okay, we are going to learn the poem that is about the leopard. Okay children, yes, open page number 10. Everyone open your page number 10 of your textbook. Yes everyone, open page number 10. Very good. Okay, unit number 1, leopard. What is the pronunciation children? Leopard, L-E-O-P-A-R-D, leopard. Leopard means chirate, it is an animal. Okay, is it pet animal or wild animal children? Yes, it is wild animal, isn't it? Can you keep it at home? No, it is very dangerous. So it is wild animal. It lives in the forest. Okay children, now I am going to read the poem. You just have to keep on moving your finger wherever I am reading. Okay children, now I am going to read a poem. You have to keep on moving your finger wherever I am reading. And you also have to recite the poem along with me. Okay? Okay children, see the first line. Once a leopard saw his spots. Okay children, just keep on moving. wherever I am reading. Okay. What's a leopard? So he spots. Okay. What's a leopard? So he spots. Lots and lots and lots and lots. Okay. What's a leopard? So he spots. Lots and lots and lots and lots. My. Oh me. My. Oh me. Oh me. Oh my. Okay. You have to recite along with me, children. My. Oh me. Oh me. Oh my. Who did this to me? Okay. Who did it? Who did this to me? And why? Okay. Who did this to me? And why? Okay, children. Let us read once again. Once a leopard saw his spots. Lots and lots and lots and lots. My, oh me, oh me, oh my. Who did this to me and why? Okay, children, so this is the poem about leopard. Okay, before going to learn the poem, let us see some new words. Okay, so here first one we have once, means one time. Once. Second one is leopard. So what is the meaning of leopard? Chirate. It is an animal. Okay. Chirate. Spots. Third one is spots. What is the meaning of spots, children? Black color marks which are present on the body of the leopard. Okay. Leopard is having a lot of spots. Black color marks. Scars. Okay, which is present on the body of the leopard. Spots means kappu chukke, small kappu chukke galu. Okay, then lots. Fourth one is lots. Lots means many, bahala. Okay, so the leopard is having a lot of black color spots on his body. Okay, children, so our today's new words are once. Yes, repeat after me. Once, leopard, spots and lots. So these are the new words which we can found in the first paragraph of the poem, that is leopard poem. Okay, children, now let us learn the poem. Okay, so here we have once a leopard. Okay, children, once upon a time the leopard got very thirsty. Okay. ಚಿರತೆಗೆ ತುಂಬ ನೀರಡಿಕೆ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಲೆಪರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್ ಥರ್ಸ್ಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಅ ವಾಟರ್. ಓಕೆ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಲೆಪರ್ಡ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಥರ್ಸ್ಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಅ ವಾಟರ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್, ಹಿ ವೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ವಾಟರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ದ ಪಾಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಪಾಂಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಳ್ಳ. ಚಿರತೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತು, ಎಲ್ಲೋಯ್ತು ನೀರು ಕುಡಿಲಿಕ್ಕೆ? ಹಳ್ಳ. ಓಕೆ, so once a leopard got very thirsty and it went to drink water in the pond. And when it went near the pond, it saw his reflection in the water. Okay, if you may see your face in the water, you can get your reflection, isn't it? So like that only the leopard also, when it went to drink water, it saw his reflection. Reflection means pratibimba. Your face, if you are seeing into the water, you can see your reflection, means your face, your whole body will reflect you in the water. So the leopard went to drink water and he saw his reflection into the water. And what did he see, children? He see lots of spots. Okay, once leopard saw his spots. When it went to drink water, it saw his reflection into the water. And what did he see? He see many spots over his body. Okay, he saw many spots. Spots means black color marks. Okay, like this. okay, it saw small black color spots on his body. Lots means many, bahala. It has a lot of spots which cannot be count. Okay, those are uncountable. You cannot count the spots. It has a lot of spots on his body. Okay, children, when it went to drink water, he saw his reflection into the water and he see the many spots over his body. Okay, and he says, Oh my God. Oh me, it's me only into the water. Oh my God. It's me into the water. Oh me, it's me only. Oh my God, it's me only. Am I looking like this? I have too many spots over my body. Who did this to me? The leopard is asking. What it is asking, children? The leopard is asking that, who has turned the black color spots on the body of the leopard? Okay. Oh my God, it's me only into the water. Who did this to me? The leopard is asking the question, who did this to me and why? Okay. The leopard is asking, why did they do like this? The leopard is asking the question, yaar madidru, eke madidru, nan body mele ishtella chukkigalanna yaar madidru? The leopard is asking. Okay, children, so this is the poem about the leopard. The leopard is asking us that who has done a lot of spots on his body. Okay, children, it's just an imaginary poem, so you can imagine it. Okay, children, nobody has done the spots on the leopard's body. Naturally, it can get, how our skin is naturally get colored, whether it is black or white, like that only the leopard also get the color and spots on his body by naturally. Naisargikavagi nam skin mele nam skin color and spots we are getting. Okay, children, so here the leopard poem is all about the spots on his body. So let us read once again. Once a leopard saw his spots, lots and lots. My, oh me, oh me, oh my, who did this to me and why? Okay, children, so the poem is all about the leopard. Okay, children, so what is the poem is about? The poem is about the leopard. Okay, children, shall I ask you some questions? Who is having the lots of spots on its body, children? Who is having the lots of spots on his body in the poem Leopard? Who is having the spots? Yes, the leopard is having many spots on its body. Okay, children, the spots are dash in color. What is the color of the spots, children? What is the color of the spots? Yes, the color of the spots is black. Okay, the leopard is yellowish in color. Okay, on the yellow color there will be a black color spots all over the body of the leopard. So what is the color of the spots? The color of the spots is black. Okay, children, is the leopard is happy to see the spots on its body, children? Is the leopard got happy after seeing the spots on his body? No, the leopard did not get happy to see all the spots over his body. Okay, children, so this is the poem about the leopard what we have learned today. Okay, children, so what are the new words we have got in the lesson, in the poem? Once, leopard, spots and lots. So you have to write these all the new words in your notebook. You have to also write the poem. Okay, children. So let us read once again. You just have to recite the poem. Okay, children. Let us read once again. Read along with me. Once a leopard saw his spots. Lots and lots and lots and lots. Just keep on moving your finger, children. Once a leopard saw his spots. Lots and lots and lots and lots. Oh my! Oh me! Oh me! Oh my! Who did this to me? And why? The leopard is asking the question that who has done this to the leopard. Okay, children. Now let us study the second poem that is about the beetle. Okay. Now let us learn the second poem that is about beetle. So what do you mean by beetle, children? Beetle is nothing but an insect. Okay? Beetle is insect, is an insect. Okay, children? We call it as in Kannada, jeerunde. What we are calling in Kannada? Jeerunde. It is an insect. Okay? It has 6 legs. Okay, children, you might have seen the beetle. Okay, children, the beetle is nothing but an insect. It's also called jeerunde in Kannada. What we call it as, children? We call it as jeerunde in Kannada. It is an insect. Okay, children, let me show you the picture of an beetle. Okay, can you see the picture here, children? So this is called beetle. It is an insect and it is having 6 feet. It is having 6 feet. 3 feet in left side and 3 feet right side. Okay. It is having 6 feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is called beetle. It is an insect. Okay, children. Okay, let us read the poem. You just keep on moving your finger wherever I am reading. Okay, children. A beetle went into a shoe shop. Just keep on moving your finger, children. A beetle went into a shoe shop. Pay attention on the pronunciation, how I am reading, children. A beetle went into a shoe shop to buy some brand new shoes. Okay, to buy some brand new shoes. I am sorry, said the assistant, but we only sell shoes in twos. Okay, but we only sell shoes in twos. But I have 6 feet. Said the beetle. But I have 6 feet. Said the beetle. What I am going to do? What I am going to do? That's easy. Said the assistant. That's easy. Said the assistant. Buy two and two and two. Buy two and two and two. Okay, children, so this is the poem about an insect that is called jeerunde and it is having 6 feet. Okay, children, let us learn the new, before going to learn this poem, let us see some new words which we have got in this poem. Okay, children, so first one, new words. First one is beetle. Okay, B double E T L E, beetle means insect. Okay, new. The second word is N E W, new. Okay, the third one is assistant. Okay, assistant, A double S I S T A N T, assistant. Shoes, feet, cell, tools. Okay children, so these are the new words that we are getting into this poem. So what are those new words children? What are the new words children? Beetle means insect, new means hasa, assistant means the person who is helping in a particular work. Okay, the person who is helping in one particular work at the shop. Shoes, okay, shoes means boots, what you are wearing. You are wearing shoes for the school. Okay children, feet means legs. Cell, cell means marudu. Okay children, tools means pair. Tools means pair, one and two, the number of shoes. Now let us learn the poem beetle. Okay children, let us have a look on the first line. A beetle went into a shoe shop. Okay children, it's just an imaginary poem. The insect never wear shoes and all that. Okay children, it's just an imaginary poem. Don't think that the insects are wearing shoes. Okay, now look at the first line. A beetle went into a shoe shop. Once upon a time, the beetle insect went to shoe shop. Okay, why it went to shoe shop children? To buy some new brand shoes. Okay, you are also going to buy shoes. Okay, you are also going, no children, you are also going to buy shoes to shoe shop, isn't it? Like that only the beetle also went to shoe shop to buy some new brand shoes. It wanted to buy new brand, okay, which is good in quality. He wanted to buy new brand shoes. When it went to inside, when it went inside the shop, the assistant said, I am sorry, said the assistant. Okay, look at the third line children. I am sorry, said the assistant, but we only sell shoes in twos. Okay, what is the meaning of assistant children? The person who helps in a particular work at shop. Okay, whenever you are going to buy something, whether it is clothes, shoes or anything, there will be a one person who is helping you to show the things. So that person is known as assistant. Okay, when the beetle went into a shop, the assistant said him, I'm sorry, we are selling only the shoes in twos, not in six, because the beetle is having 6 feet. Beetle is having 6 feet. Okay, adakke eshtu kaalu iruttave? 6. It has 6 feet. Insect is having, beetle is having 6 feet. So the assistant told him that, sorry beetle, we are selling only the shoes in pair. Twos means pair. One pair means there will be two shoes. But the beetle is having 6 feet. So the assistant told him that, sorry beetle, we are selling the shoes only in pair. Okay, not in six. So the beetle replied, but I have 6 feet, said the beetle. The beetle replied, I have 6 feet, so I need 6 pairs. I need 3 pairs, means in one pair will be 2, second pair will be 2, third pair will be 2. So the beetle replied, I have 6 feet, so I need how many shoes? 3 pairs of shoes, means there will be 6 shoes. Okay, but I have 6 feet, said the beetle. What I am going to do? The beetle asked, what I am going to do now? You are selling only twos, means 1 pair, but I have 6 feet, so what I am going to do now? The beetle is asking the question to the assistant, what it is going to do, what it will be going to do. And the assistant replied, that's very easy. Okay, that's very easy. One more new word you have got here, easy. Easy means sarala. That's very easy, beetle, said the assistant. Okay, buy two. Okay children, the beetle is having 6 feet. So the beetle is having 6 feet, so the assistant suggested him to buy 3 pairs of shoes. 3 pairs means in one pair there will be 2 shoes, in second pair there will be 2 shoes, and in the third pair there will be 2 shoes. So he replied, buy two shoes for 2 feet, and one more 2 shoes for 2 feet, means there will be 4, and one more 2 shoes for 2 feet, means there will be 6 shoes for 6 feet. I hope you have understood children. The assistant suggested him buy 2 2 2, means 3 pairs. 3 pairs means there will be 6 shoes. Okay children, in one pair 2 shoes, second pair shoes 2 shoes, third pair 2 shoes. So he can wear, look at the picture children. So he can wear first pair in 2 feet, second pair in 2 feet, and third pair same shoes in 2 feet. So there will be 6 feet, 2 2 and 2. The assistant suggested him to buy 2 1 1 pair in 2 2 feet. Okay children, so this is the poem about the beetle, the insect who is going to buy the new brand shoes. Okay children, shall I ask you some question here? Why did the beetle go to the shop children? Why did the beetle go to the shop? The beetle go to the shop to buy some new brand shoes. Okay children, how many pairs did the beetle buy? How many pairs? 3 pairs. In first pair there will be 2, second pair there will be 2, third pair there will be 2. Total 6. Okay children, have you understood the poem? Who helped the beetle in buying the shoes children? Who helped? The assistant helped the beetle in buying shoes. Okay children, so this is the poem about the beetle who is going to buy the new brand shoes. Okay children, now let us read once again the poem. You just keep on moving your finger. A beetle went into a shoe shop to buy some brand new shoes. I am sorry, said the assistant, but we only sell shoes in But I have 6 feet, said the beetle. What I am going to do? That's easy, said the assistant. By two, two, two. Okay, children, have you understood? Now it's time to give you some homework. Yes, take down your homework, children. Write new words. Two times. You have to write the new words two times in your homework notebook, children. Okay, you have to write the new words of the first poem leopard two times and beetles new words you have to write two times in the homework notebook. Hope you all have understood today's class. Let us meet in the next session with the new poem that is called There Was a Young Girl Called Maggie. Okay, children, hope you all have understood today's poem. Let us meet in the next session. Till then, have a good day. Bye bye.